I think a lot of it is from misunderstanding and a lack of education by these people and a lack of knowledge on what this country is built on. We're a small little island and we rely heavily on people and people's skills. This, you know, when you go home, you're watching your television on usually a Chinese or a Japanese television, you're driving a German car, and then you're out here trying to get everybody out. It doesn't make sense. And then they're having a Chinese at the end of the night as well. So yeah, I find it quite strange, and yeah, it's demoralizing to know that people in society can reach such a low point in their lives where attacks are happening, you know, blatant racism is happening. Yeah, it's just sad to see, really.
Well, I feel threatened, scared to come out of my house, because Muslim people, we're not terrorists. That's how I feel. Like, I feel like we're being threatened. It's not safe. What we do as Muslims, we just pray 5 times a day. You know, we're not terrorists. That's against our religion.
Yesterday I saw a video from Liverpool, and it was quite terrifying because I saw that they are striking the black people, the women, even some of the kids as well. The thing is that, you know, they're blaming for nothing us. You know, I came over here on a student visa. I paid all of my NHS fees, visa fees and everything. I'm still working full time. I'm paying the full tax. So I'm working myself. I'm not getting any benefit from the government. I'm working for this country as well. So there is no meaning that we are doing any wrong thing with the country, with the people over here, you know. Everyone deserves to have a beautiful life, a peaceful life. We just want to have this over here, you know.
Yeah, I feel very stressed and it's very distressing moment in our life. We never seen this kind of far-right group active against anti-immigrant. So we are living fear and anxiety. This could be anything could happen to us, and we are living fear.
The Muslim communities are terrorized. If I'm gonna use the word, they are terrorized. They fear. They fear for their safety. They fear that they cannot go out. They fear that anything could happen. Like we saw that taxi drivers have been attacked. So people cannot really go and do their day-to-day job realistically, because Uber drivers have been attacked, taxi drivers attacked, women are threatened, mosques vandalized. And this is becoming the kind of, in the last few days, the activity that is happening on a daily basis across different regions in the UK.
I had a COBRA meeting this morning, which was an opportunity that I took to thank the police for their work over the last few days, to express my support for the police officers who have been injured and the communities impacted by this mindless thuggery. There are a number of actions that came out of the meeting. The first is we will have a standing army of specialist officers, public duty officers, so that we'll have enough officers to deal with this where we need them. We'll ramp up criminal justice. There have already been hundreds of arrests. Some have appeared in court this morning. I've asked for early consideration of the earliest naming and identification of those involved in the process who will feel the full force of the law. And thirdly, I've been absolutely clear that the criminal law applies online as well as offline, and I'm assured that that's the approach that is being taken. Whatever the apparent motivation, this is not protest. It is pure violence, and we will not tolerate attacks on mosques or our Muslim communities. So the full force of the law will be visited on all those who are identified as having taken part in these activities. Now, my focus is on making sure that we stop this disorder, that the criminal sanctions are swift and be seen to be followed, which is why I've asked for consideration to be given to the earliest identification and naming of those that are involved in this. Many have been arrested, some have been charged, some of them are in court now. We're entitled to know who they are so they can be identified at the first opportunity.